Hi viewer, I welcome you to Edim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, lesson number 18. The topic it is Action of the River. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson goals. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to highlight the features resulting from the river deposition and also look at the river profile. We start by looking at these features that result from the river deposition. We have the alluvial fans, we also have the meanders, we have the oxbow lakes, we also have the braided river channels, natural levees, floodplains, and deltas. Let us have a look at these features. Alluvial fans. It is a fan-shaped deposit of fairly coarse material laid down by a stream with a large road as it emerges from a steep, narrow valley into a wide, gentle plain. Deposition takes place when fast-flowing river in a constricted valley channel loses its velocity on entering a plain. And an example, we have the Ombane fan that is found in Kano Plains, and that is in Kenya. Number two, we have the meanders. Meanders, these are loop-like bends in the river course that develop from sluggishness of a river due to the decrease in the gradient. The loop-like bends. The river, therefore, flows slowly and tends to fall around, flow around an obstacle instead of cutting through it. Once a bed develops around an obstacle, the water current pushes hard on the outer banks, causing maximum lateral erosion. So in this case, now you get the maximum lateral erosion. That is what end up to the meandering of the river. The river water comes to a temporary standstill on the inner bank, causing the river to deposit alluvial wealth at the same time eroding the outer bank. So we have deposition that takes place at the inner bank, while erosion it is at the outer bank. The meander grows bigger and more pronounced due to alternate deposition and erosion on the inner and the outer bank respectively. They are common in lower course of the river Yara, Mirui, Zoia, Nyando, Tana, and Sabaki. Let us have a look at them, how they look like. You can be able to see how the meandering of a river looks like. You can see how the channel is eroding on the outer bank and depositing materials at the inner bank. The third one, it is an oxbow lake. This is a horseshoe crescent-shaped lake formed on the front plain of the river. Active lateral erosion takes on the outer side of the beds, narrowing the meander neck. The meander neck is eventually cut through. So this one tells me that we should start from the meandering of the river. We get the meander. Then when the meandering of this river continues, finally you are going to get the meander neck. That is the lateral erosion and deposition. Meander neck we get. And then finally it cuts down. That is how it is formed. As you can be able to see, we start from the meandering of the river. After that, the meander neck is formed, where now the lake is formed, just adjacent to the river. Now, The cut end of the meander are sealed by the deposition, and the meander now becomes an oxbow lake. And an examples of this lake, we have Lake Kanyabori, we also have River Yala, Sharu, Birisa, Gambi, on River Tana. All those ones, they are found on River Tana. That is Sharu, Birisa, and Gambi, they are found on River Tana. Activity for today. With the end of diagram, explain how an oxbow lake is formed. For those you want to refer, you can get the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3, that edition. You can get us either through the SMS, you can also get us from the YouTube, you can also get us from the Facebook, and you can tweet us. Stay tuned to the RMTV. Thank you.